Hello and welcome to this James Bond podcast called Die Another Day. Sa jag till dig? Die Another Day. Starring me, Ponty Forsland. And today I am here and we're gonna talk about Oberhauser, you know, the villain from Spectre. And I'm gonna tell you right now, spoiler alert, because I'm gonna talk about the character Oberhauser and also the character of Ernst Stavro Blofeld. So if you haven't seen Spectre, turn off immediately and watch Spectre, and then you can come back to the podcast here. Anyways, today's episode, it's about Oberhauser. And you know, it was in Spectre revealed that a man called Hannes Oberhauser got the custody of James Bond after his parents had died and his aunt Charmaine sent him to Austria. Hannes Oberhauser had a son called Franz Oberhauser, and it is revealed in Spectre that Bond had thought all along from his childhood onwards that Oberhauser and the father and the son, Hannes and Franz, had died in an avalanche. But it turns out, spoiler alert, that it was Franz, the big brother, you could say, of James Bond, had killed his father and survived this avalanche, coming back as evil Spectre number one, Ernst Stavro Blofeld. But do you think that this was just something made up from the screenplay writers of Spectre? You are a bit wrong, because that is actually something that has been picked up from this short story, Octopussy, written by Ian Fleming, the creator of James Bond. And you recall, perhaps you knew this before, but Barbara Broccoli, the daughter of legendary producer Albert R. Cabby Broccoli, she got the advice from her father: when in doubt, go back to Fleming. So that's what the new Bond movies have done in a way. They go back to Fleming, take small details from the novels and short stories and elaborate them into a part of the screenplay. That is exactly something they have done here with Hannes Oberhauser from Octopussy. And I'm gonna read something here from the short story. But first I'm gonna light this candle in a cozy atmosphere. Okay. Octopussy by Ian Fleming. Page 15. This is a short story about Major Dexter Smythe getting a surprise visit from James Bond. James Bond said casually, "Does the name of Hannes Oberhauser ring a bell?" Major Smythe frowned, trying to remember. "Can't say it does." It was 80 degrees in the shade, but he shivered. "Let me refresh your memory. On the same day as those documents were given to you to look over, you made inquiries at the Tiefenbrunner Hotel, where you were billeted for the best mountain guide in Kitzbühel. You were referred to Oberhauser." Okay, so Major Dexter Smythe, you might remember from the movie Octopussy. In the movie Octopussy, starring Maud Adams in the title role, Dexter Smythe was the father of Octopussy. And Roger Moore said that he had tracked him down and charged him with the fact, or explained to him the fact, that his tour guide had turned up dead and a lot of gold bullion had disappeared. And he had, Bond had given him 24 hours to set his record straight, but he had committed suicide instead, and this was Octopussy really grateful for. So there's actually a link between the Movie Octopus and the movie Spectre. But it's in a very dodgy way. Do you follow? I think you do. Anyways. The story is here in Octopus that Oberhauser, he was the mountain guide for Dexter Smythe. They found some Nazi gold in the Alps. And Dexter Smythe killed Oberhauser and got away with the gold. But now the dead body of Oberhauser had been revealed several years later. And Bond goes to Dexter Smythe. But why is it Bond that goes to Dexter Smythe? Just a minute. I'm gonna read now. But how did you get mixed up in the whole thing? Mob force was our responsibility by service. The papers found their way to us. I happened to see the file. I had some spare time on my hands, said Bond. I asked to be given the job of chasing up the man who did it, the murder of Oberhauser. Why? Said Dexter Smythe. James Bond looked Major Smythe squarely in the eyes. It just happened that Oberhauser was a friend of mine. He taught me to ski before the war, when I was in my teens. He was a wonderful man. He was something of a father to me at the time when I happened to need one. And it is these two quotes that they have elaborated on in the movie Spectre and created a side story of Oberhauser not being killed by Major Dexter Smythe, like in the book and in Octopussy, but his own son, Franz Oberhauser. So that's the literary link between Ian Fleming and Spectre. Some of you perhaps didn't know that. As for Blofeld, I'm gonna do a special episode of Die Another Day, so till dig, Die Another Day, about Ernst Stavro Blofeld. I'm just gonna show this, that this is Thunderball that we have discussed earlier in the Spectre episode. It was the first time that Blofeld appeared, and he appears in numerous various appearances. A bit dodgy, the whole thing about Blofeld actually. But more on that later on. That was some stuff about Oberhauser and Spectre and the link between Ian Fleming and the movie. So stay tuned for more James Bond vodcasts. My name is Ponty Forsland. And you are watching Die Another Day, sa jag till dig, Die Another Day. The only Swedish James Bond vodcast, I think. But stay tuned for more episodes.